this on before 5 minutes gone, or Charlie will come to your home. You will hear him, not see him. He will teach you to fear him and watch you when you're alone. But when it's your time, 1 minute past nine, he will hide in the shadows and taunt you. His smile will find you and fear will blind you and take you away to die. If you don't forward this email to 15 people in the next 5 minutes, Charlie will come for you at 9 p.m. tomorrow night.
That's beautiful. Thank you for that story, mate. Are you going to forward it on?
No. Nah.
You want to send it, don't you?
Nah, I'm not.
You are ridiculous.
Well, you never know these kind of things, do you?
I do know these kind of things. I've ignored loads of them, and none of them's ever come for me.
None of them was this one, though.
No one was this one. That's very true. Very much. I have to go now. My girlfriend's here. But you have a good time. Don't be too frightened, okay? When you're sat here by yourself and I'm off doing Rumpy Pumpy.
Yeah. Are we having some myself, mate?
Having some Rumpy Pumpy yourself? Yeah. How are you going to be having Rumpy Pumpy yourself? Who with?
Got a girl coming around.
You got a girl coming around for Rumpy Pumpy?
Got a girl coming around for Hanky Panky.
Alright, fine. Well, have fun with this girl you've got coming around. I hope you have a good time.
I don't know. What are the fingers for?
It doesn't matter what the fingers are for. If you don't know what they're for, mate, I don't know what you're doing tomorrow night. Right, I'll see you later. Alright.
Have a good time.
Yeah, you too, your imaginary girlfriend. I'm all right, Poppet. How you doing?
Yeah, fine. You got everything?
I've got everything. I'm ready to go. I'm raring.
You got your toothbrush? Be like your bloody mother.
I'll go to the garage. You get one when we go to the garage.
Yeah, that's fine. I need to stop for petrol anyway. Is that all right then, Johnny? Johnny, what are you looking at?
I think I'm going mad. That's what I'm doing. Come on, let's go. Let's go.
Okay.
I'm gonna party. I'm gonna get all up in your grill, you know that?
Hey, I was just ringing to let you know that I wouldn't be able to make it tonight. Obviously you haven't picked up, so I'm leaving you a voicemail. I'm really sorry, I hate having to cancel on you, but something's come up and tonight's just not going to be possible. But I'll give you a ring at some point and we'll rearrange. Yeah, so I'll see you later.
What's going on, mate?
What do you mean?
The past few weeks you've been very distant. Are you unhappy here?
No, I like it.
Lee, I want this to be a comfortable and open place of work. I know you have a young child, and it can be difficult. You're struggling at home. Money issues, lack of sleep. It's a very tough time.
No, we're fine.
You can confide in me. I know your private life has nothing to do with me, but I'd like to know what's going on when it comes to your work. Recently, your work's been suffering. Even 5 weeks ago, you were asking me about high vacancies in the department.
I know. I'm sorry.
Whatever it is, sort it, so we get back on track. Does that sound fair?
The police.
Okay, we'll get patched through.
There's someone at my house.
Okay, you need to try and get out of there.
They're blocking the way out.
What do you mean they?
I think there's more than one.
What makes you think that?
I can hear them.
You can hear them?
Yes, I can hear them.
Have you tried going out the window?
Yes, I've tried. It's locked.
Thank you.
Stop, go upstairs now!